Hi, I'm ChaseS5127 2.0, and I am the founder of the Baby Einstein community on YouTube. And if you would all like to have more information on the content that I post, please visit my channel, leave a like, and click the subscribe button to show your support. Enjoy the show. Hey there, YouTube. I'm ChaseS5127 2.0, and welcome to my current Baby Einstein toy collection. Now, if you've been watching my previous collection videos, you should probably know that my magic puzzle cube is once again missing another puzzle piece, and I need your help to find it. It's a oddly shaped green puzzle piece, and there we go, right there. I still don't even know why I'm losing the puzzle pieces to begin with. Anyway, we should probably know the drill by now, so once I connect the piece, the toys, which I'm going to show to you in a second, will pop right out. Once I connect it. Ready? 1, 2, 3. It looks like the magic puzzle cube has only managed to bring out only half my current toy collection. I'll be able to present the second half as I'm finishing presenting the first half that you see. Some of you may already know what toys I already have, but again, I'm going to show you exactly what toys I have in my collection, and I am also going to go through this as quickly as I possibly can. So without any further ado, let's get started. Here we go. All right, so the first toy I have for you all is something I've actually managed to hold on to for a very long time. This is supposed to be the Free Circle Perpetual Motion toy that I got from Office Playground. I remember seeing Baby Mozart for the first time, and the Tri-Illusion toy, the one with the red and blue sides, that's the one that stuck to me because it was so intriguing the way it was spinning, like how you see it right now. I couldn't find the exact one, but this was the closest thing I could have, and I'm glad to actually own it, let alone keep it for a very long time. This next toy is also a kinetic motion toy, but I believe it's probably the most common to get out of any one of them. Here's the Cosmos kinetic motion toy, but I got this one from Office Playground as well. The first time I saw this toy was on Baby Bok when I was little, and like the Tri-Illusion toy, I couldn't find the exact same model even though I really wanted to, but looking back on it now, it doesn't really matter if it has colors or not. It's still the same toy, but I really like the fact that it's like spinning with the magnets and all that. You can kind of tell that there's the magnets like right at the bottom and like right in the middle of the toy. It's still pretty cool to me either way. Anyway, this next toy, it's one of my personal favorite kinetic motion toys in my opinion. So this one is the Galaxy Perpetual Motion toy. Again, I originally saw this one at Baby Mozart, but the actual color scheme of this toy was originally shown in Baby Galileo. I kind of like the way it's spinning with like the rings around the red ball in the middle. I think it's really interesting, in my opinion. The one little problem that I have with this toy is the mini red ball that you see that's spinning around with the middle blue ring. It's always hitting against the pink ring, which I don't really like, but other than that, I think this toy is really cool to watch. It's satisfying to see all the rings just spinning around once again. Alright, and this next toy I have for you is another one that I've also managed to hold on to for a very long time. This is the Jupiter Perpetual Motion toy that I also got from Office Playground. The exact toy was originally seen in Baby Bok. And I kind of like the concept of the two pairs of metal balls swinging back and forth, spinning around with the magnet in the middle. I think that's pretty cool. But with my specific toy, it for some reason just stopped spinning. I'm guessing the 9-volt battery in which I insert into it doesn't exert enough power for it to keep going and keep spinning around like how the actual toy does in Baby Bok. I'm not sure. That's always been a problem for me, I guess. Okay, this next toy I'm going to show you is another one that I really liked to play with when I first got it. This is a spinning balls kinetic motion toy that I also got from Office Playground. This toy was originally featured in Baby Galileo, but my specific toy, you could kind of already tell by looking at it that there's not a lot of color into it. There was when I first got it, and I guess after some time, it just faded away. And when I first made my kinetic motion music videos, I used to oversaturate the picture for this toy specifically like this. And even after looking at the picture now, you could barely see any color from this toy. which is still kind of a shame because I really wish the color was still a part of it. Okay, the next toy I have for you is another one that I also really like. Like the Free Circle toy, it's the Free Balls kinetic motion toy from Office Playground as well. I'm not sure if this toy was featured in a Baby Einstein video. You can correct me if I'm wrong in the comments section. But it is, like I said, similar to the Tri-Illusion toy from Baby Mozart, with the way the metal balls are attracting to the magnets, or in this case, repelling, so they spin around. I kind of like this toy just because it's pretty similar to the Tri-Illusion toy, and I thought, hey, why not? Why don't I get this toy? Okay, now we're at the halfway point of this toy collection. And this next toy I'm going to show you is something that has been in the background of some of my old videos from my previous channel. It's a lava lamp by Lava. It's actually pretty cool. I mean, at least until you sit it out for a little while. So the switch is how you activate it. The light goes on right there. And I know it's kind of hard to see because of the light, but I'm going to try and zoom in and see how I could get a better picture of it. I know it's kind of hard to see as it is. Okay, so I believe this is the best view I can give you for right now. You can kind of see that there's like a little green bubble just about to like pop out inside the lamp. I still think the lava lamp itself, it's pretty cool. At least until you have it sit out for a little while. Ooh, that's hot. Alright, so I'm going to move on to my next toy. It's actually a really rare one, and I was able to get this off of eBay. Here's the Polaris Kinetic Mobile toy from Carlisle. And if you know your Baby Einstein videos, you can tell that this was the exact same color scheme toy from Baby Shakespeare. And actually, I think I still have the exact same box from when I first got it. Let me go grab it real quick. Here it is. So I think the box itself is pretty cool, the way it's actually detailed. Yeah, let me move this out of the way. Still gotta let it keep going though. So here's the top, the front, the left side, the back, which requires one 9-volt battery, the right side, and the bottom with the barcode. Overall, I think this is a pretty cool toy, but I just wish like the thing itself would continue spinning just a little bit more than how it actually is, because you can't really tell that it's spinning too much. Alright, this next toy I have for you is the woodpecker toy as seen in Baby Doolittle Neighborhood Animals. This woodpecker toy, as you can kind of tell, has a yellow feather head, and I remember using this toy for a Baby Van Gogh remake, and I thought it was pretty cool because when I first saw it on Neighborhood Animals, I was like, how is it doing that? I'm like, I don't know, I just got kind of confused the first time I saw it. I mean, I was little at the time, so this toy was another intriguing one to me, I guess. Okay, this next toy I have for you is one that has also been featured in Baby Bok. Here is the Spinning Disco Ball by AADLP. Let me turn it on for you real quick. I remember winning this exact disco ball from a Dave & Buster's arcade, and I couldn't pass the chance to go ahead and get it. I know lots of arcades, to my knowledge, offer disco balls as a prize, and since I had enough points, like I said, I couldn't pass the chance. I had to get it right away. It looks pretty cool, by the way, with all the colors spinning around, and every now and then when I turn it on and off, it spins around in the opposite direction. I don't know if it was supposed to do that or if it's something that could have been like an error. I don't know. Anyway, here's the next toy I have for you. Here's the Rocket Tornado Lamp by The Lion Company. This toy, as you can already tell, has been featured in Baby Mozart initially. And I'm going to try to zoom in on this quickly. Let me see if I can get a good view on it. Alright, here's the switch to activate it. Here we go. Now, you could kind of tell that there's a little propeller at the bottom of the lamp that starts bringing down all the beads to form a tornado. And I still want to try to get a better view off of this. This is not really good. Let me zoom in real quick. I'm sorry. There we go. Here's, I think, the best view I could get for you. So, another one of the best toys I have, in my opinion. I like the way the beads are, like, all coming down and spreading around and everything. And, like, coming back up to the top and just going around in a repeated cycle. I think that's really cool. The only bad thing about this is that the liquid level on this tornado lamp specifically is not high enough like other tornado lamps are. Like the one in Baby Mozart. The beads are a lot more spread out and a lot more dispersed in that video. But this one specifically, it doesn't really do that. But the toy itself is really good. Especially when you turn it off like you see here. Alright, now we're moving on to the last toy I have in this collection here. It's the Alien Orbiter by Uncle Milton. The toy itself has been originally featured at Baby Mozart. But the one I have has actually been featured in Baby Van Gogh. Let me get a better view on it. Here we go. And I want to see if I could get like a good detail, show you exactly what they are. So there are three different holes that you're supposed to blow into. And I don't know if you can really see them. There's like a 1, 2, and 3. The holes are labeled as well. And there are three more additional small holes at the bottom of the toy. There's a small fan in the middle of the toy as well, and that's what the holes are for. So you just blow into it, and then you just keep going and going until it gets faster, and then that's how it balances it out. And that's the stand that you're looking at right now. Yeah, I had to speed it up because it took me a while to balance the toy out. This toy actually glows in the dark as well, which is pretty cool. I can't really show you in the video, but here are some pictures I have of it. It looks pretty cool when you're looking at it, and I think you just have to shine enough light on it in order to have it actually glow really well. Alright, I hope y'all enjoyed this video, and if you have enjoyed it, of course you could always leave a like, and you could also leave a comment telling me how you thought. And if there are any requests, you can put them down in the comment section, and again, I will try to fulfill as many as I possibly can. And until then, I will see you all in my next video.